Every now and then, we add a new or updated tool to Lightroom that, at face value, doesn't look like much. But in reality, it's something so overpowered that it can fundamentally change the way you edit your photos. As far as I'm concerned, we added such a tool to the recent Adobe Max 2025 Lightroom update, and it's called Color Variance. Now, Color Variance may look innocuous enough, and I could understand if you totally overlooked it, given that it's a single slider added to point color, a tool we first introduced 2 years ago at Adobe Max 2023. However, as soon as I saw the Color Variance slider many months ago, I instantly knew that it would play a huge role in my Lightroom workflow. And the cool thing is that Color Variance is very scalable and that it has a role in both landscape and portrait photographers' workflows. And that's exactly what I'm going to show you right now. So let's dive in. All right, so before we dive into anything, let me take a quick second to introduce you to someone. His name is Max Wendt. He's right over here. And Max is the developer who brought us the Color Variance tool. He actually brought us the entire point color panel. And so if you remember, Color Variance first was introduced in Adobe Camera Raw a few months ago. And we just introduced it to Lightroom at Adobe Max 2025 a few weeks ago. And this is also a good point. Color Variance is available in Lightroom 9.0, in Lightroom Classic 15.0, as well as in Lightroom Web. So you have various surfaces where you can use this powerful tool. But again, I just wanted to take a quick minute to introduce Max. He's a brilliant guy. He's a great guy and a hell of a photographer. And also, in case you don't know, this group here, this is primarily the Adobe Camera Raw team, or at least a portion of it. We went on a photo trip the other week, and this is in Kings Canyon National Park. We were there photographing here and in Sequoia National Park. All right, let's get back to Lightroom. So I mentioned how the Color Variance tool has a place in both portrait and landscape photography workflows. And so let's start with portrait. So this is a photo that I downloaded from Adobe Stock, and it allows me to illustrate how the tool works really well. The way that you can look at what Color Variance does is it does one of two things, depending on the direction that you move the slider head. You can either increase color contrast, meaning separating colors within a certain range, or you can decrease or harmonize colors by dragging it to a different direction. And again, I'll show you what that means. I'll explain how it works in kind of this portrait capacity, why you'll want to probably harmonize in these situations, but also, especially in a landscape situation, why you might want to increase color contrast. So here, if we zoom in, you can see there is a bit of a variance in the complexion. So you can see the cheeks are a bit darker and other areas of the face are a different hue. Same thing here. You can see that the cheeks are especially darker here. And what I want to do is I want to bring some harmony. I want to reduce the color contrast in the faces. So how can we do this? Well, if we scroll down, we are in the edit stack over here. So this is the global editing tools. You can see here's point color and there is variance over here. And of course, the thing is, if we use point color in the edit stack, it will apply global edits. So what does that mean? Well, if I take this dropper here and I select this color and I adjust the variance slider, you see how it's adjusting this color within the range, but within the whole image as I drag it left and right, which I don't want. In these situations here, where I think point color is most valuable is when you bind it with the masking tools. I've said this many times. I believe that the masking panel is probably the most powerful section of Lightroom. So let's go ahead here and delete this swatch and let's go to masking. Now, because I loaded a portrait photo and Lightroom detected that there were two people, it automatically created these two masks for me, which is very helpful because what I want to do is I want to apply variance separately to each of these faces. The amount of variance that I apply to this face will be different than this one. So let's start with this person over here. I'm going to zoom in over here, center her face, and then let's click on person one. And then Lightroom also will identify different components to the person it detects. And so I really just want to adjust the facial skin. So I'll click this and then click create. Now, I always recommend renaming your masks first. So let's just do this right now. And I'm going to call this CV for color variance, face person one. All right. So how do we use the variance tool here? Well, with point color, the first thing you always have to do is use this dropper here to select a certain hue. Now, with variants, the way that we recommend you use it is to select a color that you kind of want to push other colors to or away from. In this case here, I recommend selecting kind of a mid-range color. What I mean by that is click on the dropper here. I'm not going to select the darkest area within this range. I'm also not going to select the brightest, but I'll select something right around here, kind of this mid-range. And now I've got this variance slider here. You can see this is the swatch we selected. If I take the variance slider and I drag it to the right, this will increase color contrast. So what we're doing is we're pushing the colors in this range away from each other, and you can see this pretty terrible look. However, the real magic is when we take the variance slider and we drag it to the left, and what we do is we reduce the contrast between the colors in that range, and you can see how we're kind of harmonizing. The skin looks a lot more even. Now, of course, you can bring this all the way to the left over here, but I find that this can sometimes give you a bit of a plasticky complexion, which you probably don't want. So I think it's okay to keep a little bit of that color contrast visible over here. And if we toggle the mute, you can see that this is the unedited photo and just the absolutely amazing job that we were able to accomplish here. Like if we zoom out, let's zoom to fit just to see in context, like you sometimes forget where you start with and where you're able to get with just a few clicks and the drag of a slider. So once again, let's zoom in again. And one of the things that Max told me as far as like a tip is in terms of working with masks, the recommendation is to make your point color adjustments on a single mask. So here, if you want to, for example, increase the luminance shift, maybe drop the saturation shift just a tiny bit, and I'm not going to touch hue, but basically what I'm doing is I'm making all of my point color edits on a single mask here. And if there are other edits that you want to make to the facial skin, you can go ahead and create a new mask. Again, select the person and then select facial skin. And then here you can go ahead and make other edits. But his recommendation is to keep the point color and the color variance edits on one mask and then move on to create a different mask if you want to apply any other edits. But in this case here, I don't want that. So I'm just going to delete that mask. Now let's go ahead and move on to person number two. So I'm just going to pan over here. And just like before, let's create a new mask, except this time we're going to select person two, and then let's select facial skin and select create. And so again, we're going to do the same thing. Let's go down to point color. Let's use the dropper. Let's select a mid-range. So again, not the darkest, not the brightest. I find maybe right around here looks good. This is kind of the color that I want to push all of the other colors towards. Again, dragging to the right will increase that color contrast, but dragging to the left, we get this really nice smooth skin. Like the complexion looks a lot smoother. And another thing we can do is if you did not get kind of like the full range of color with this one swatch, you have this range slider here. So if I drag this to the right, it's going to allow more of the color within range. So instead of looking at the face, look at this section here while I drag the range slider. If I drag it to the left, you can see how it gets really, really constricted. And you can see that some of those colors fall out of our edit because we became very, very strict with the color range. However, as I drag it to the right, we're allowing more of that color within that range to fall into play. And so if we toggle, you can see it really is amazing what we're able to do here in terms of a portrait setting. Now, if you're looking at this point color panel and you're not sure how any of it works, don't worry. I will link to a deep dive video at the end of this one where I explain exactly how the point color panel works. But again, let's go ahead and zoom to fit and let's just hit the backslash key. So that was our original image. And then with point color, I mean, the ability to get that smooth complexion, that kind of harmonized skin color is just truly amazing. All right, so that was a pretty clear illustration of how the color variance tool can fit in a portrait photographer's workflow, especially, like I said, if you're trying to get that even complexion without having to do a lot of finagling, you're literally working on one slider. It makes things a lot easier. But for me, obviously, I've done like far more landscape photography than portrait photography. In fact, I had to go to Adobe Stock to find that image. But as a landscape photographer, there's been one thing that has been plaguing me for years. And that is I love using a polarizer filter. I use it all the time. In fact, I think it's probably the landscape photographer's most important accessory next to a tripod. The problem is that depending on the focal length that you are using, especially wider focal lengths, and your direction with respect to the sun, and of course, how much you engage the polarizer, you can get this kind of unwanted byproduct where if you look at this image here, do you see how kind of like the sky, there's this like dark section here, and then it's brighter here. This is just the reality of using a polarizer in a landscape photography setting. Now, that doesn't mean that I would not use it. Like, I love using my polarizer. But I will say that with the advent of the color variance tool, it makes this issue almost moot. And so what I mean by that is, let's say I want to even out the sky. Like, I want to kind of create a more even sky because I do not like this effect. Part of the reason is, as I edit, like if I add, say, an S-curve to this image, or I go ahead and I add, for example, dehaze, let's say I created a sky mask, you see how it's accentuating that kind of inverted bell. And this dark pattern is not always kind of this bell shape. Sometimes it'll be in the corner, left or right. And again, that depends on your position with respect to the sun and also how much you engage the polarizer. So let's go ahead here. I'm just going to undo the dehaze and get rid of that slight curves adjustment. Now, the same principle that I just showed you applies here, where with the previous portrait photo, remember that I used masks. Point color works in a global and a local environment, and I only want to adjust the local area of this image, specifically the sky. So fortunately, if we go to masking, we have the adaptive sky mask, which is phenomenal. It'll automatically make a sky mask for me. And just like before, I'm going to go down to point color. I'll select the dropper over here. And you can see, look at that giant color picker preview. You see how it's kind of dark, and as I move it to the right, it gets brighter. Like the blue gets brighter. You see? It's actually quite visible as I go left and right. And so I don't want the darkest area. I don't want the brightest. I kind of want to select the blue that I want to push the entire sky towards. And that's really right around, maybe right there. And so now, again, if I take the variance slider and I bring it to the right, you see how it's just accentuating. It's pushing the colors away. However, if I bring it to the left, now we're getting somewhere. Now we're getting to this really nice, even sky. I can also increase the luminance, increase the saturation a bit, and even push the hue more towards this blue over here. Now, remember, you have this range control. If I bring it to the left, look over here. Look at this area over here. As I bring it to the left and then to the right, do you see how when I remove some of that blue from the range, when I constrict it, it actually falls out of the point color range? And so if I bring it to the right, we get a much smoother transition. So definitely play around with the range slider in conjunction with variance and these three HSL shift sliders. Again, if we toggle this, do you see how even it is? Of course, it's more blue because I adjusted the hue and saturation shifts. So let's go ahead and let's turn those off. Let's just toggle with luminance. And you see just how much more pleasing this is. At least it is more pleasing to me to have that even sky. All right, so I just showed you two examples, a portrait and a landscape photo. But in both of them, we use the color variance tool to decrease contrast. We drag the slider to the left to create a bit of harmony in the skin and also in the sky. But let me show you an example where you might want to increase color contrast or separate colors away from each other. In this case, it's a landscape photo. It's an iPhone photo I took many years ago. Obviously, it's just a fall foliage shot. I kind of like it, but let's say I want to separate. I want to push these colors away from each other. Well, I could use a mask, but in this case here, I don't think it's necessary. I'm just going to apply a global edit. So we're going to scroll down to point color, just like with the other two examples, except again, we're in the global edit stack. Let's go ahead and select the dropper here. And really, it depends on which color you want to kind of start pushing away from. So I'm going to select something right around here. I feel like it's a good mid-range color. And then again, if I took the variance slider to the left, you see how all the leaves are really starting to look kind of similar in terms of the same yellow. But if I take variance and I push it to the right, we start to really get this separation between the colors. And it becomes more pronounced when you take the luminance shift, for example, you make it brighter and add a saturation shift. And now things really start to pop. Just like before with the range slider, if I bring it to the left, it's gonna kind of let more of the colors fall out of range. So I'm gonna bring this more to the right because I want more color to fall here. And you can see if we toggle point color, just like what a beautiful job it does in terms of separating those colors. Of course, I can go ahead and make this even brighter. I can move the hue shift a little bit here, a little bit more of a saturation boost. And this just looks super vivid. Again, you can see here just what a great job it does in terms of pushing these colors away from each other. And I find that this is probably one of the best examples of using an increase in color contrast is with these kind of fall foliage shots. So you'll definitely want to experiment with your own photos. And so I hope you now see what I mean when I say that the color variance tool is so overpowered. It's just one slider. But depending on the hue that you select with the point color dropper, depending on whether you increase or decrease color contrast, it could have a fundamental impact on your photo. And that's what I mean again by something being overpowered. Now, the color variance tool is just one slider. Point color is just one panel. If you want to learn everything there is to know about Lightroom for desktop, mobile, and web, please check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. If you don't know what point color is, no worries. I've got this video here, or YouTube can tell you what it thinks you might like. Of course, if you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and click on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.